Hello there. Welcome back to Goetia, where we read the journal of Abigail's sister, Anne, who summoned a demon. There's only this light to illuminate the whole room. It's so dark and oppressive. There's a massive book on the shelf. It must be important. Might be somewhat altered, but even so, there's no way I can read that book without finding out how to get out of this showcase. Okay, there's a lot of things to select, which is annoying. Okay, so I already selected all those. Let's check this out first. Pencils, notebooks, and newspapers. So this was the... So it's like, this is the mother. Mother is Abigail, right? Since you will not listen to reason, I must stop you myself. I apologize for stealing your notes, but I see no other way. Gabriel may be the oldest, but he has no idea what you are up to. I will be back for young Edward and Robert. I forbid you from trying anything with them, or you will dearly regret it. This has gone long enough. So she went crazy. So they took, she tried to, the other person took the kids. And she has, like, a few other kids or whatever, right? Okay, so let's try to, I guess. Father may not have been fond of horses, but this statuette is gorgeous. I don't remember it either. Okay. Okay. I thought there'd be more, but I can't enter the thingy, so. The box contains some kind of white powder. Okay. I used to hide in this wardrobe. Annie never found me in here. Can I just, like, leave it? A hollowed skull, one of Mother's eccentricities. Supposed it must have come from the upstairs library. Okay. I guess I could continue with this. The pen is mightier than the sword. The treasures do hide in the written word. I should try to remember this. Okay. Also, it keeps all the papers. That's cool. Oops. I didn't mean to do that. Okay. Let's go upstairs again. I can't go that way. What is this box for? What is that? Feathers? Holy fuck. Good evening. That scared the fuck out of me. Who are you? Oh, come now. You wound me. We are already acquainted. Of course, it was some time ago, and you may not have even seen that I was there. I am one of the kind your father did so love to talk about, even if he elected not to teach me much about me in particular. I don't know why I can't read this. Okay. Even if he elected not to teach you much about me in particular, my current form, shall we say, should be something of a hint. You're one of the demons that father was studying, a raven. You must be Malthus, but demons don't exist. It was just an unpleasant hobby of his. I suppose you must be right. After all, that would be simply absurd, not unlike believing in ghosts, perhaps. I must say I am rather surprised to see you right here right now. No matter, I am almost flattered you recognize me. It means that mankind has not quite forgotten about me yet. Not completely, at least. What do you want? What do I want? Oh, I see. Abraham must have taught you that I would require a favor if you were so impertinent as to summon me. But in your case, young lady, I chose to appear before you. You did not summon me, and thus we can dispense with the quid pro quo, I suppose. I simply want to do, well, chirp with someone, perhaps. Chirp, fine. But what are you doing here? Aha, now that is quite an interesting question. Would that I could answer it. You mean you don't know? Not exactly. I do recall that I was summoned, but in a most unusual way. Annie, she called me, and we chirped for a time. But she deceived me and trapped me within these walls. All I know is that some part of me remained in the cozy confines of hell, while the remainder, well, is the manor itself, or something like that. Like when I possess an object? It does indeed seem that the same forces are at work here. And why are you preventing me from going any further? I am doing nothing of the sort, or rather not consciously. You see, my girl, we are both pure spirits here, and it seems that our essences cannot collaborate, shall we say. I promise I would simply love for you to proceed. I dare say that you are the only who can... Why can't I read? I dare say that you are the only who can free me. The sigil on the ceiling, could it be a hint, an answer? Ah, such a keen mind. If it is not the answer itself, it must be part of it. My sigil is not complete in this form. It cannot be seen by man. Much in my immense sorrow, the sigil you see only represents half of my being, the part that remains in hell. There's another sigil, in fact. It is the opposite of this one. It represents the part of me that is trapped here among the living. Should you manage to find it and decipher it, I would be freed to leave this world. I knew you wanted something, after all. Exposed. Yes, it seems we both need each other. I expect that I can rely on you. You have black wood blood running through your veins, after all. If you'll pardon the expression. Okay. Wait, you... He disappeared. Not quite. Do keep up the good work, Abigail. Simply forget that I am watching your every move. Alright. We're good. We'll keep going. Okay, so I can't go there. Holy shit, there's a lot to look at. Okay. Okay, this seat was... Of course, father's armchair. The silver medallion holds the portrait of a door-looking man with sharp eyes. Okay. This ruined tower reminds me of the one of the villagers we're talking about, the woods on this estate. There's dear Mrs. Ward, the housekeeper, and she has her keys even in this painting. Edward Hodgkin, 1940, 10 years old. I will never know the taste of this wine. Alexander Hodgkin, 28 years old. August 1939. Wait, 1939? This is 1940, so Edward is Alexander's son, I would think, right? Young daddy, but Annie Hodgkin, 1940. Annie Hodgkin. Annie as a grown-up, I still recognize her, though. Gabriel Hodgkin. So who's Gabriel? Was that her, like, past husband? And then Alexander's her, like... current husband or something? Robert Hodgkin. Okay. Glasses are still full as if people left in a hurry. Okay. This dumbwaiter is connected to the kitchen in the basement. Am I able to go in here? What am I supposed to do here? I don't know if that did anything. Well, I made some sort of progress here. Smoked garlic. I used to love that smell, but the memory is fading. Well, it's been 40 years, yeah. Ooh. Ooh, okay, it's a puzzle. Okay. Okay. Like right here. I'm sorry, guys. This is like really weird to control. Probably around here. Okay, so my young brother. It's been a while since I haven't put your keen mind to the test. How would you feel about a paper chase? First clue. Chariot. Happy hunting. Okay. Chariot. These plates haven't been properly washed. The meals weren't finished either. There's a sheet of paper on the wall, but why is it blank? How odd. If it's not the right powder, maybe I'll at least be able to make some nice fireworks. It reads the eldest birth. There's no food on these shelves. No one's planned on settling in here. Okay. Something preventing from going any further. It must have something to do with those strange metal sheets bolted to the wall. There's a combination lock on the door. A thick metal door made out of lead. Okay. I have no idea for those ones. I hate number ones. I'm really bad at these kinds of puzzles. So I apologize. Can't just go through it, right? I need a number. I can't go down through that, okay. This is Malthus. Are there other demons in here? If Malthus is in the like above the dining room. How do I get? Forty, 31 years old. Chariot. Okay, well, this one's gonna be a bit harder for me because I am terrible at puzzles. But we'll see. We'll see what I can do. Oh, I left it. Yeah, didn't mean to do that. Can't go anywhere other than here, right? So I need the code to that room. But where do I get that code? Be a pen. Ooh. What would be a pen to help though? I don't mind that I could be a pen. That's cool. Does that allow me to do anything though? This might take me a while. That was loud. Kind of terrifying. I'm a little lost on what I'm supposed to be doing. I need a hint. So I got a pen. Like, I'm assuming I'm supposed to do something with it. Can I put that here? Okay. Let's go downstairs. See if I can do anything with a pen. Okay. Anything I can do over here? No. No downstairs or anything, right? The eldest birth. That's a clue. The eldest birth. Okay. Wait here. Who's the eldest? So. Well, her. Okay, she's technically the eldest. So it'd be 1-1. Okay, so November 1940. Robert Hodgkin. have anywhere on their birthday, though? 1940. The eldest birth. Okay, let me try to figure out something. So we're going to look at this, all right? This is completely wrong because I'm just putting in the date that I see the most, but no, okay. The eldest birth. Where does that mean? Maybe it's in the notes. I didn't even go up there. I'm stupid. Okay. Okay, so Robert is 14 years old. So, how do I do math? He's 14 years old in 1940. 40 minus 14 is 26. Yeah, right? Twenty-six. Am I wrong? 3? Okay. That was the best I could do. I might have to come back to this. I'm not smart enough for this game. Give me a moment, guys. I'll be back in the next episode. Once I grow a brain.